Hi, welcome to Barney Tech channel.
Here we are going to see about how to test pole slip production in relay. Most of them, they do testing by some OCC file or any predefined file for testing this pole slip production. And some of them, they will do randomly increasing or decreasing the current and will show the trip to the customer. I promise to you all, after seeing this video, you all going to test this production with full confidence. First, we will see the relay setting. I am going to show on ABB relay. This is the relay setting. For this settings, I am going to do testings. In this settings, ZA, ZB and ZC are in percentage. We need a value for testing this production. First, we have to convert this percentage into value. ZA equal to Z base into ZA percentage. Similarly for ZB also, Z base into ZB percentage. Same for ZC also, where ZA percentage is 140%. It is nothing but 1.4. We have to multiply just by 1.4. Same way for ZB percentage is 0.9 and ZC is 0.75. We have to check in the relay. The voltage and current rating is kept correctly or not. That is on V base, I base. Because for this production, it mainly calculate from the base value. For converting this percentage into impedance value, we have the formula. Now I am going to find Z base. Formula for this Z base is V base by I base into 1.732. So V base here is, we have taken as 25 kV and I base taken as 3000 amps. So when you substitute and simplify, we got Z base equal to 4.811 ohm. Now I am going to find ZA. ZA, when I substitute Z base into its percentage, I got 6.735 ohms. For ZB, I got 4.33 ohms. And for ZC, I got 3.608 ohms. Now we can see for sample graph. In this, x axis is for R value and y axis is for reactance value. ZB is a generated impedance and ZC is a transformer impedance and ZA is a impedance for the system. Here for ZA, ZB, ZC, all the value which you are taken for calculation is all reactance value. Now we will see how to draw actual graph for the value which we calculated. For x axis, we have to take R value. For y axis, we have to take x value. This thing can be drawn by using graph or in paper. For these two axes, we have to take a equal scale. After making this scale, we have to draw one reference line. By taking R as a reference axis, from that we have to make 75 degree. This is the angle pi, the settings which was given in the relay. Then take 0 as a reference and first we draw ZB. And the value here is 4.33 ohms. It is a reactant value. So we have to take the point on y axis. For generator, we have to take minus because it is backside of the relay. So draw line below over the reference line. Next, we have to take 0 as a reference and draw line for ZC, which is transformer reactance. We have to draw on positive quadrant over the reference line. The value we calculated is 3.608 ohms. Again, take 0 as a reference and draw ZA. Draw ZA in a positive quadrant. For ZA, that is 6.735 ohms over the reference line. Now, draw perpendicular line on ZC. Now, we separate two parts. The lower part is zone 1, the upper part is zone 2. In this, we have three conditions. One is fault occurs in our area. We say N lesser than 1. Next, the fault occurring in other end. For that we say n is greater than 1. The third one is fault on between the zone 1 and zone 2. That is exactly the center point. Here we say n equal to 1. We have a three condition where n equal to E1 is our end voltage, E2 is other end system voltage. Now I am going to test for n lesser than 1 condition. For that I am going to take a various random point over this curve. Over this point I am going to note x and y value, that is R and reactance value. Now I am going to test the pole slip production in state sequence. For that I need corresponding voltage and current value for this resistance and reactant. For this we are going to form a simple step. In that I am going to fix voltage as a constant 10 volt and I am going to simulate the symmetrical fault so all three phase is have a 120 degree phase shift. And all this value which we have to calculate and which we calculated and which we know, all I am going to make in one tabular column. I am going to stimulate symmetrical fault, so for each phase angle should be 120. Now we go for calculation. For the three phase fault, Z equal to V by I, where I is equal to V by Z. Case 1, the value which I have taken from the graph, I am going to substitute and calculate. After calculation, I got 1.434 angle 59.3. We are using symmetrical fault, so each phase current, the phase shift should be 120 degree. So for R phase, IR equal to 1.434 angle 59.3. Correspondingly for Y phase, IY equal to 1.434 angle minus 60.61 and IB equal to 1.434 angle 179.38. Similarly, we have to find for all value. Now we are going to make a test module in Omicron kit. For that, just click on test universe. Over here on test module, the fourth option we have state sequence. Over there, double click on it. Defaultly, it will have a single stage. Initially, the stage should be in healthy. Because our system is going to be healthy, then it going to be fall to the pole slip. We are going to stimulate similarly. So the first stage should be healthy. On left side corner, you can able to see the detailed view on state sequence. We have to configure on triggering. Over there, select binary input also. And check binary input condition should be in R, because we keep timing as well as triggering of output from the relay. Next we will see how to add new stages. You can able to see the stages which is on the menu. If you select that stages, you can able to see the stage after and stage before. In that, click on stage after. Then for that few following stage, we have to change the healthy system into the faulty system which is nearer to the calculated one. I am going to keep in 45 millisecond. This time should be in millisecond only, because on pole slip the fault will be in keep on moving very fastly towards the zone. Remaining all stages I am going to make as per our calculated value. After finishing all stages, we can stimulate by pressing the start button. This method will work for 100%. You can think how it's going to be work. I'm going to show how it's going to be work. For example, I'm going to check this point which are selected randomly. Let me see from this point. From this point, when we stimulate, the relay will start to check the start angle between ZA and ZB, which will be around 90 degrees, which is lesser than the start angle on the relay setting. When the stimulation will move on next point, the relay will check again the phase angle between ZA and ZB. Now it is greater than 110 degrees, so the relay will start to pick up, but it will not give any trip, only alarm it will produce. And then it is, the point is going to cross the impedance line. Then over the point, it will be checked by the relay, the angle between ZA and ZB again. But this point, the angle will be compared with trip angle. The angle now over here is greater than 90 degree, so it will not give any trip. But when we move to the next point, this angle is lesser than the 90 degree, so the condition gets satisfied. Next, the relay will go for checking the limitation in that particular zone. It is a zone 1, so it will check in N1 limit. On the relay settings, it is only 1, so it will give the tripping finally. Here the number of slip for zone 1 is 1. Our relay we stimulate is also 1 pole slip, so the condition gets satisfied and it gets tripped. Suppose in N1, if they keep 2 or any 2 pole slip we want to check, then we have to make that 2 state sequence similarly. And for this 2 pole slip, it should be happen within this reset time. We have the here reset time. For example, if it is 5 seconds, the second attempt of pole slip should be within this 5 seconds. Otherwise, it will go for reset. And testing of this pole slip, we have a various method. In that, I have shown only in state sequence. It will be very easy, so I have shown over here. Same way, we can check the pole slip for zone 2 also, and for n equal to 1 condition also, by selecting the random point similarly. Next, we will see the reason for pole slip. If the earth fault occurs nearer to the generator terminal point, then n will become very less. That is, the zone 1 pole slip will occur. If the excitation problem also can cause the pole slip production, even if the heavy load on grid get tripped, then also the pole slip production will occur. Next, we will see the effect on pole slip production. The pole slip production is very severe fault, more than the short circuit fault. Due to this pole slip, even the shaft can break down. If our generator got pole slip fault, then it has to be isolated. If not, this effect will be affected to the network on the grid, and it will directly affect the generator which is connected to this network, and it may cause the blackout condition. I believe that from this section, you all have the clear idea about testing of pole slip production. On next video, I am planning to make a negative phase sequence production.
We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.